Bonjour! Hi! Welcome to another video of Cloud in 5 Minutes. I'm Frank Boucher, and today I want to talk about how to create a LAM VM with Linux, Apache, MySQL, and PHP. Because it's not only the Microsoft stack that is available on Azure. Si vous préférez, j'ai une version en français de ce vidéo. Cliquez juste ici, en haut à droite. A very popular environment for web development is LAM with Linux, Apache, MySQL, and PHP. Of course, you could create a VM in Azure with your Linux favorite distro and configure your MySQL and your PHP in it. But the purpose of today for this second quick start on Azure video is to have a VM that is already prepackaged for us. Let's get started. We'll create the VM using the portal. So, let's go to portal.azure.com. Now, from the top left, you will click on this Create a New Resource button. Now, we'll search simply for LAM in here, this search box. There you will have a lot of options, but the one I like is here, LAM Certified by Bitnami, because that one is already prepackaged for us. Let's create it by clicking the blue button. Now, I need to fill that form with simple question to create my VM. I need to pick my subscription, that's fine. Now, I need to pick a resource group. A resource group, it's a logic group where all the resources will be sitting. We'll come back later. But for now, let's create a new one. So, create new, and we'll just call it Frank Demo. Now, we give a name to our VM. So, I will call mine Frank LAM VM, and you pick a region. So usually we'll pick a region that is close to you so you get less latency. Like I was mentioning, you could specify a different image, but we already pre-select the certified by Bitnami. You could change your size, have a very beefy VM, but for now I will keep it as it is. So now to connect to our VM, we'll need a credential. So, of course, you could use the SSH public key, but for me, since I'm just demoing, I will use a user password. So, click here, this option. I will use Frank as a name and a password. I could go in every step and specify the size of the disk and everything, but since it's a demo and since I want a quick start, I will keep everything by default. So just before the VM is created, we have a last validation. So in one page, I will have all the information concerning my VM. It's very interesting because right now, a lot of information was pre-selected for me. So here I could see how much will cost my VM by hour. And if I scroll down, I will have all the other information. If I'm interested to have the ARM template to create the exact same structure, I could click here down below, the download the template automation, that's the ARM template, so I could use that in an automatic deployment. So now let's create it. So after a few minutes, you will see it's very quick, all the resources will be ready. So let's go in the resource group to see what we have. So we'll click here in my resource group. There it is, I have my VM, a VNet, an IP, a storage, and everything I need. Everything was created for us. So now, we need the IP of the VM and the application password because Bitnami, to configure our VM, created a password and we need that one. So let's go here in the VM, we'll click on that. And here it is, my IP. So I need to take note of that. So like I told you, the VM is already configured. Let's open a new tab and just paste the IP. And there it is. We have the default web page. So the VM is ready and waiting for us. Now a tool that is very useful when we play with LAM is PHP Myadmin. To access it, we need to create a Ssh bridge. So let's go in the terminal. So we need to create a bridge between the local host, so 127.0.0.1, and the VM with 1382, 236, and 40. That's the VM we created in Azure. So we want a bridge, an SSH bridge, so we will remap the port 8080 to the port 80. So we'll execute this, and of course, we agree. And now we need to enter the root password. That's the password you created when you create the VM. So it should be working. Let's go back in our browser. I will open a new tab. And now we need to go to localhost 8080 and PHP Myadmin. That's great, we have it. But one thing that we still miss is the application password. So to get that one, we could connect to the VM and look in the files, but we have that information directly in the portal. So go back in the Azure portal and we'll go in boot diagnostic. So if I scroll here that panel, close to the bottom, I have boot diagnostic. I will click on that and I will go check in the serial log. The password was created at the end. So scroll down close to the end and here it is. You have the setting bitnami application password, so application password. So note this password since it will be used to connect to everything that was configured by bitnami. Great, so now that we have it, we could connect to our PHP Myadmin. I just need to enter it and I have the tool, everything is there. Perfect, but of course I still want to connect remotely to my VM. To do that, we'll go back in our terminal. I will open a new tab and I will connect using SSH. So SSH and then frank with the IP of my VM. And now of course I need to enter my password. And there it is, I'm connected to the VM. I could do everything, I'm on Linux and it will be working perfectly. Let's say for example, I want to connect to the MySQL. I could go MySQL. And there it is, I'm in MySQL. And voila, and there it is. In only a few minutes, you're ready to code. Now it's up to you to create a nice web application. If you want to know more about Azure, click here, another video of Cloud in 5 Minutes. See you next time. Thanks.